Hi, everybody. My name is Ramiro Calderon. I'm a principal product manager in the Azure AD team.
Hi, everybody. My name is Michael Epping, and I'm a senior product manager in the Azure AD product team.
So as part of our job, we talk to a lot of customers, all verticals, all kinds of scenarios, and every customer that we talk to has macOS in their environment. So in this video, we want to talk to you about what do we have for those macOS users in Azure AD. So Michael, why don't we start by sharing with the group how the macOS system traditionally has worked so far and how we progress into like getting the cloud scenarios into it with Azure AD?
Sure. So when we talk to customers about macOS, oftentimes what we initially talk about is how are they actually signing into the Macs themselves, right, and not so much about connecting to Azure AD to start out. So historically, the way that this has worked on Mac platforms have been through a combination of various Kerberos-related features where the Macs can be tied to an on-premise Active Directory. So it's very common for our customers to have some sort of tool deployed, either native to the Mac or a third-party tool, that helps them basically keep the local account in sync with the on-premise Active Directory account.
Yeah, and that works great when you are in the corporate network, in the building, or with a VPN, but very traditional architecture. So when we start doing like more modern auth stuff or working from home, those kind of interactions start to fall apart a little bit, right?
Yeah, and this has been the experience we've had with a lot of customers is, especially in the COVID era, where users are not always on the corporate network, where the domain controllers might be for doing Kerberos, and more applications and resources are moving to SaaS and M365 and other services you might tie to Azure AD, the story kind of starts to fall apart where you can't get a token from a domain controller to authenticate in a seamless fashion to your services anymore. We really need something that's a little bit more modern and built on top of tokens and Azure AD. So this is where Apple has, in the last couple of years, given us some functionality built into macOS, where IDP vendors like us can come and build some functionality that sits on top of Apple's framework to provide SSO to our IDP, which in this case is Azure AD.
Right. So as you can see, and as I can see, you have a Mac over there. So why don't we just show the viewers what is the experience, and then we break it apart in the technical angles.
Sure. So let's take a look at what this actually looks like. So I have my Safari browser here. So this isn't Microsoft software. This is Apple's browser. And all I'm going to do is type in myapplications.microsoft.com. And I got to type it correctly. And I'm going to hit enter. This browser had no pre-existing tokens, no cookies, nothing of any sort. And you can see that I didn't have to provide any username or password, and that I am automatically signed into my application that's tied to Azure AD. So I'm getting a nice, smooth SSO user experience, even though I hadn't previously signed into this browser before.
Yeah, so that is a perfect demo because it's super boring. There's nothing under the covers that interrupts the user. It just works. So how does that work from the technical angle?
Yeah, so let's take a look at how this actually functions within the OS. So you're going to have your Mac, and then the key requirement is that you need to install the Microsoft Company Portal application. Customers will often use this to enroll into a service like Intune for MDM, but you don't actually need to use Intune as your MDM. If you use a different MDM, that's totally fine. You just need to make sure that the Company Portal is installed because it has our SSO extension inside of it. Then the user is going to actually authenticate the SSO extension. So this can be done by opening the Company Portal app, or if you follow our recommended configuration, it can be done inside of a different application instead, like Safari or Outlook or Teams or some other app that's integrated with the broker. So when the end user does this, they can use any Azure AD credential. So unlike the on-prem integrations where you're probably just going to use username and password, here you can use passwordless authentication with the Microsoft Authenticator app, or you can do username, password, and some form of MFA. What'll happen then is that after the company portal is authenticated, it will get from Azure AD what's called a primary refresh token. So just like an on-prem Active Directory, you might have a Kerberos ticket granting ticket. From the cloud, you get a primary refresh token, and this is used to maintain state with Azure AD, and we can use this to provide SSO, which I'll show you in a minute. And a key thing to remember is that primary refresh tokens are good for a rolling 14-day window. So as long as the user is constantly using their Mac, it's going to be refreshed over and over again.
Yeah, it's interesting, couple things here. So in the demo, you had no problems whatsoever. It's like very seamless and not intrusive. That was because you, some point in the past, followed these steps and got prompted to authenticate to Azure AD. And then after that, we're just silently rolling in that 14-day window.
Exactly. I signed into the SSO extension a couple of weeks ago, and my PRT has just been refreshed over and over again over time.
So it's very similar to the architecture of what we do it in the iOS environment or in some other platforms where you have that PRT pattern that just bounces through the broker up.
Exactly.
Gotcha.
So now let's take a look at how this actually worked in Safari. So this is what we call the redirect flow. So there's actually two different flows, and we'll start with the one that I showed you. So the user tries to access an application that's protected by Azure AD. In the demo, I showed MyApps, but it could really be anything that's integrated with Azure AD. And here's where some of the special sauce that Apple built into the platform comes into play. Instead of that application going to login.microsoftonline.com to ask for tokens, the network traffic to that URL is actually redirected by the macOS network stack to a broker. So this is defined in an MDM profile that you push to the device, but that traffic is intercepted and passed to the SSO extension broker, which then uses its PRT to go to Azure AD and request a token. If everything checks out and the PRT is valid, it'll get an access token or a token of another form back from Azure AD. That token can be given to the client application, and our user gets access to their app.
Yeah, that's very similar to how we do it in Edge and the Windows platform. The one question that I have there is, like, if you say macOS network stack, what happens when the applications are not using that stack and they have their own?
Yeah, so there are some applications that don't necessarily use the macOS network stack. For some, they don't necessarily integrate with our broker because they have their own implementation. But there is another flow where applications that use other patterns can actually integrate with the SSO extension. And this would be using the Microsoft Authentication Library, or what we refer to as MCEL. So MCEL applications can talk directly to the broker, so it can bypass the macOS network stack requirement, go directly to the broker and say, please use your PRT to get tokens for me. And just like before, the SSO extension will use its PRT to ask Azure AD for an app token, and then that token will be returned, passed to the client application, and it will get access to its service. So this is the other flow where you can use the Microsoft Auth library to bypass the need to use Apple's network stack.
Gotcha. So it seems like it's a no-brainer for our customers to go on and deploy this, right? Because it's seamlessly integrated with the browser already. So every application that uses a browser, like a SaaS app, will just work right there and then. And then it seems like for these kind of applications that probably our customers are developing themselves, they can just use our libraries to just have that free benefit of using this seamless pattern to access their applications.
Right, I would agree. Generally, we think that pretty much every customer should go deploy this. So as long as your Macs are being managed by an MDM, you can go deploy this profile through your MDM channel, get it pushed onto your Macs, and start providing an improved user experience for your macOS users.
So like most customers in our enterprise scenarios already are managing their Macs with either third-party products or Intune, and then they just can take advantage of this right away.
Yep.
All right, folks, so there you have it. Thank you so much for your time. Hopefully you find this video useful, and stay tuned for the next one.
Thank you.